Thanks for joining us tonight. Police officers, EMTs, firefighters, they all put themselves in harm's way for us. And we know they deal with really difficult situations. This weekend was no different for officers in Burnsville and in Woodbury. Both cities dealt with emergency calls. First, we'll start with Woodbury. It was a standoff with a man held up inside a house on Tahoe Road, and it wrapped up this morning. Those on scene worked for 5 hours to get that man in the house to surrender, and thankfully nobody was hurt. And then we go to Burnsville, still suffering from what happened there 6 weeks ago. This time, two officers suffered minor injuries during an 8-hour standoff that started Saturday night. A woman with a gun was inside a home on Buck Hill Road. She was eventually taken into custody. And as I said, that comes less than 2 months after two Burnsville police officers and one firefighter paramedic were killed at a standoff. In light of all of that, it's hard to comprehend how much of a mental health toll it takes for officers who responded to this incident in Burnsville on Saturday night. And Kent, you looked into a new training for mental health professionals to help first responders.
Yeah, I did, Jana. And for years now, we've heard about how increased violence and decreased staffing has taken a toll on the mental health of officers across the state. But in order to address that issue, we need more people equipped to talk with them about the dangers unique to that job.
It's hard to imagine responding to a standoff, let alone after spending a year watching coworkers getting killed doing so, all while spending several years stretched thin due to staffing concerns. But this is the state of policing in Minnesota in 2024.
You have big T trauma and small T trauma, and they have both piling up. It's a catch-22, right? Because the more they do, the harder it is to do it well.
Solange Ribeiro is president of Adler Graduate School in Minnetonka, which has spent several years advocating for more specialized training to those counseling law enforcement and their families.
This whole thing started at the time of George Floyd's murder. Even in our presentation, we had police chiefs who came to argue for the need of the program.
That testimony led the legislature to approve a grant for low-cost training last year.
We want as many people out there in the community as possible that can offer assistance.
Associate Professor Tom Watson says the goal is simple.
To get them to have a little bit more of an understanding, what is it like emotionally? What is it like physically for those individuals who are risking their lives running toward that danger while everyone else is running away from it?
Who can complete that training and who is taking that training right now?
They are all licensed professionals who have done work in the field. Some of the attendees are spouses of law enforcement officers. Some are currently working with law enforcement officers.
What has the demand been like for those looking to get the training?
Oh my goodness. In our grant budget, I had put a certain amount of money for marketing. What marketing? We were full within 24 hours of having the card saying we were going to offer this.
What does that tell you?
It tells us two things, that there are mental health professionals who want to work with law enforcement and who are seeing the need.
Speaking of that need, following the deadly shooting in Burnsville, which happened during the second of six planned trainings, they are looking for ways to deploy that support even faster.
We are already receiving requests for individuals who have completed the program. When something like this happens, a tragedy like this happens, it impacts the entire community.
It's the old cliche, but that it's true, that we all do better when we all do better. By taking care of our peace officers, we are really promoting public safety.
Now, once the six trainings funded by this grant are completed early next year, the plan was to create a directory so that departments across the state could access more help. But because of the demand happening in real time right now, we're told they are now offering contacts as they complete their training. Essentially, they will have a registry available when it's all done. But if departments are calling and needing help right now, they're providing those that have completed it.
We heard so much in the days and weeks after the tragedy in Burnsville about needing this kind of help, and they could get it now if they need it.
They absolutely could. And this is something that is very unique, they said, to those law enforcement officers, but also their families, because it's such a critical time for those that experience it from both sides.
Right. Everybody goes through it. All right. Thanks so much, Kent. Appreciate it.